Hidden Meaning of Truth and Untruth, Part 24. Piyush Mehta.
Jai Sachidanand Pujyashree. Ever since we started the satsang trip from Dar es Salaam, I started noticing some things in Piyush, like his faults. I started to observe some things that happened in Dar es Salaam, Mombasa, and same things that happened in Nairobi and in Naivasha. I started to notice some things.
What did you notice?
It was mostly about seva, or giving service, and seva-related activities. Before attaining this Nyan, the problems that were happening in another institution that we were involved with, when I used to go to that institution, what would happen is that two groups would get formed, that of wealthy people and another group of not-so-wealthy ones. This used to happen in that institution. So what I had seen there, I started observing the same thing here in relation to seva. When your program to come here was confirmed, many seva teams were organized here for all areas as to who will do what seva. Since you were coming after 2 years, Mahatmas were very excited to do seva. So the responsibilities were given to different teams and they were handling their seva well. What happened then was, I know that all of us have the intent to do Dada's work. We understand all that. But what happens is when Mahatmas come from outside and the teams that are given the seva responsibility are handling it with enthusiasm, and even the Mahatmas who have come from outside are doing it with enthusiasm. But internally, Piyush started thinking that the people who were initially given the responsibilities gradually started to leave, or they were driven away. And the others started taking over those responsibilities and started doing everything. Now the local Mahatmas weren't saying anything, they were just observing things from the sidelines. So my intellect started interfering in this. I saw the same thing in Dar es Salaam, the same thing in Mombasa, in Nairobi as well, and yesterday I saw that here. Now, Mahatmas don't say anything, and I wonder if I should say something or not. When I look at them, I see some pain in their eyes. They probably felt we were given the responsibilities, we had gotten the opportunity to do seva after 2 years, but Mahatmas from outside are taking charge of our seva and our responsibilities.
What do you mean by from outside? You mean out of Nairobi?
The ones from outside of Kenya.
Out of Kenya?
The ones out of Kenya.
From Kampala or elsewhere?
The group that's come here, from that group.
You mean our Mahatmas, who've come from India?
Yes.
They're considered ours. The ones here are also considered ours. Those are also considered ours. But we mean the Mahatmas who came with us.
The ones that have come with you, yes. But internally, I feel that
all they only want to do is help. We don't want to hurt anyone.
I also realize that everyone has the intent of doing Dada's work properly. But I feel that there are many Mahatmas from Kenya who can't afford to attend retreats here or in India. They only get a chance when you come here, which is every 2 years. When you come here for 2 weeks, that's the only chance they get. Some only get a chance for 3 days if they're in Nairobi, or if they come to the retreat. We try a lot so that they become acquainted with you, they come in touch with you, they do seva. When all this started happening, I even did a samik. I didn't see anyone's faults. I know everyone has the intent of doing Dada's work well. Now, if we were to tell anything to the Mahatmas who have come from outside, they might get hurt. They might feel, we're doing seva, what's wrong with that? On this side, the Mahatmas from Kenya weren't saying anything, because they had just left the seva, but I could see the pain in their eyes. So if I take the route of Nyan, I feel that everyone's doing Dada's work, but if I look at it from a worldly viewpoint, I feel that this is slightly wrong. Since the topic has come up, I want to know what's considered truth and what's considered untruth in this matter. I don't understand it.
What's this like? It's best to develop teamwork in a way that, if it's in Kenya, with Mahatmas from Nakuru, Mombasa, or Dar es Salaam, everyone should get together and create a team. The teamwork should be such that if anyone wants to do seva, for example, if someone wants to do seva at the bookstall, you can tell him, meet the team lead. He'll guide you. If he needs more people, he'll involve you. If he doesn't need anyone, then he'll say no. This way, if someone says, it's kitchen seva, I know it, I'm doing it. No, wait. I want to serve the meals. wait, meet our team lead. We should develop the team in such a way that if anyone wants to be involved in seva, if he goes through the team, we won't feel burdened. If the team has a need of 5 people, or if the team has a need of 7 people, and there are only 5 people available, it'll absorb 2 more. Problem solved. If we feel all this is entirely my responsibility, and I have to handle everyone, then that creates another problem. He'll say, why are you saying no to me? If we don't act as an individual, but if the team says, then team means everyone has gotten together and decided on things. This way, we have organized the team in this manner. These are the departments. Each coordinator has these many group sevarathis or volunteers. All of them will work together and complete the task. This way, everyone gets involved. And if anyone wants to get involved, if someone comes straight to the bookstall, the team can tell him, wait, you'll have to ask the team. Have you asked our team? Do whatever the team says. That way he won't feel hurt. If we say by ourselves, don't come here, let others work, he'll reply, who are you to tell me anything? The ego reacts in this manner. In a team, there's no ego because everyone has gotten together and arranged things. So by being together, solutions come about.
In Kenya, they arrange things by doing teamwork. So in Kenya,
teamwork.
It hasn't happened before, but it happened this time, and my intellect also came into play.
Then reset it. If anyone wants to handle a responsibility, they'll have to go through the team. For those 50 people who've come from India, they should be told in advance, if anyone wants to do any seva, consult this team. Help according to whatever the team says. Even they have coordinators. You can tell them too. The people who have come with you, please take care in the coordination. We've set teams here. This way, everyone finds a solution. For example, if chairs need to be arranged in the hall, and those Mahatmas have come in early and are sitting idly, so they think, let's arrange the chairs. And if you say, no, our team has said no, only we will arrange them. Hey, let them arrange the chairs. What is this like? We don't know who came first and who started helping, but we feel that some local Mahatmas have been left out, but they may have come late.
Pujashi, the main problem is for seva that's in your connection, such as stage decoration, cooking for you, or serving you food. The main problem happens there. There's no problem in the other areas.
Even for that, there should be preparation in advance. How many times is he going to eat here? He's going to have 4 meals here at so-and-so locations. So how many sevarathis are here? We have these 25 people. 4 meals, so make groups with 6 each.
Pujashi, we have done all that here.
So what's this like? We've arranged something, but depending on what happens in Vyavasthit, rearrange it in a new way. It's like, improve from where it has spoiled, take it forward from where it has been stuck, be complementary to each other, and use the intellect for solving problems. Use Gnan to ensure oneness and pure love don't break. Bring this solution in worldly interactions. Whatever design got executed. Now for the next event, again, sit together and discuss what can be changed, what mistakes were made. What this is like is investigate how many Mahatmas from outside got involved in seva and took charge of it. How did all this happen? It happened because of this. He was idling away and someone needed help. Please help me lift this pot. And then he got himself involved. Oh, really? If not like this, how should it be like? Arrange it like this. Next time, use the intellect to find a solution for work. Moreover, we don't have to be the only one using it. Sit down with your team of 15 people and discuss. What can be done? What should be done? Ask some experienced people who've come from India. How do you organize seva in a Dalit? How do people help? Share your experience with us. Find a solution together. Finding a solution is the crux of the matter. If we keep investigating who did this and accuse them, these people are like that. Next time, a different group of 50 people will arrive. They won't know about the arrangement made here. These 50 people weren't aware. They come and just roam around after getting ready early in the morning.
There's fresh air here, and because of the amount of oxygen here,
The body doesn't need as much sleep.
There's good water here, so it helps in better digestion. So they get up early and roam around. And they join in wherever help is needed. So we have to rearrange the system.
What often happens is, we get really happy when outsiders do seva. We tell them to not have any divisiveness and perform dada seva with oneness.
No, not like that. Despite that, arrange a system. If we say, do not overcrowd here. For example, if there's Deepak Bhai's darshan and we announce, we're starting darshan now, all of the mahatmas in the front will be the first ones to rush forward. If you were to tell them now to get in a line, they won't listen to you. They think, Pujyashi is right in front of me. Why should I get in line? I'll extend my arm like this and my darshan will be done. So these 15 people don't budge. What you have to do is arrange a system. Arrange the chairs like this and like that, stop the flow from here, and then tell them come from there. But you have to let go of these 15 people. Do your darshan and gradually leave from this side. As for the remaining 250 people, the line is for the remaining 250 people. But if they say, those 15 people took advantage, why can't we do the same? But you have to tell them, no, you're in the back, so get in line. You're sending us in the line? Those people were allowed. That's because there wasn't a system then. It was a mistake. Now we've made a system. If these people had arranged the system earlier, even those 15 would have had to get in line.
I know that the 50 Mahatmas who have come this time won't come again the next year. But Mahatmas here feel that if they were to say something to the Mahatmas from outside, they would get hurt. It would create divisiveness. Dada's work.
No, no. That's why we have a team. Then no individual has to speak. What does a team mean? The end of an individual's liability. That's a team.
But Pujyashi, we form a team and seek solutions.
Yes. Then send him to the team. Please meet the team. So we only directed a person to the team. We didn't raise any objections. The team members will discuss and tell him. We have made this arrangement. Sorry. He'll reply, okay. He'll be fine.
We fear that if we say something, they'd get hurt. Should we say this or not? How should we handle that part?
No, but the team. What does a team mean? Look, when the 50 people arrive, tell them on the very first day. Tell them before they even get to Dar es Salaam. They should know what they're supposed to do at the airport itself. If guidance is provided beforehand, then they already know what the system is. For darshan, you have to join the line from the back and then move in the front, do darshan, then take a left, circle back and sit down. They already know that beforehand. So they won't run straight for darshan.
Okay, I understood.
What's this like? It's because the system, actually during every darshan or every program, the organizers say, calm down, proceed slowly. Why does this happen? Why didn't you do this? There's no need to say all that. Check what the flaw is in the system. That's what we observe. Where did the deviation happen? Why did this start to happen? They're coming from anywhere.
For example, elderlies take their wheelchairs and come straight in for darshan. So the line of 10 people suddenly stops. Then I change the system. Tell them to join the line. Make them enter from the back and join the line of 10 people so they gradually come to the front and then leave from the side.
So by continuously changing the system, we brought about some improvements. This is for darshan, but for every program, be it dining, etc., in Simandar City for years. Hold on to these 5 sentences. Improve from where it has spoiled. Don't find faults in anyone. Take it forward from where it has been stuck. Be complementary to each other. And use the intellect. Use the intellect tremendously, till the end of your capacity, but for finding solutions. And not to disturb anyone, not to find anyone at fault, not to bring anyone down, not to dismiss anyone. Find a solution. Gradually, it will be solved.
Jai Sachidanand.
Sangeeta, Pragna, Mombasa.
Jai Sachidanand. When children enter their teenage years, a lot of problems happen. Until what limit should we make them understand or tell them? We keep an eye on the circle of friends they're in. If someone is improper in that circle, we tell them to leave that circle and move away. but they don't leave that group. We make them understand that this is for their benefit, but they don't like our point. So what's the limit as to how much we should make them understand?
If we can't handle giving a medicine, take them to a doctor. I tried to medicate them for 4 days, but the cold isn't going away. Headache and cough are getting worse. Fever has started. Take her to a doctor. If you try to medicate them on your own...
I have done that, but it's still going on.
Yes, but what else can you do? Their age is such that all this arises. What were we like at that age?
Yeah.
What all did our mother teach us?
She never said anything.
How much did we listen to our mother? How much did we follow her?
But Pujashree, we weren't so bad.
We weren't like that. These people have become bad. Nevertheless, however they are, keep giving them understanding. To impart understanding means to add 1 teaspoon of sugar, not 22 teaspoons.
I understood all that today, and I'll be careful about it. But what I feel is...
And whatever you have to tell them, when you say it verbally only once, but make a phone call to the self within her and say it 10 times. 10. Keep a ratio of 10 to 1.
Pujashree, I do try that. But ultimately, after 2 or 3 days, I end up telling her something.
Yes, that happens. But did you verbally say something to her after saying it internally 10 times? Or did you say something to her straight away?
No, I do say the prayers.
Yes, pray 10 times. O pure soul, let her find closure and inner satisfaction. Shower your grace on her so that she attains the right understanding. Grace her so she comes out of bad company. Pray 10 times, then verbally say it once. Before that, pray, O Dada Bhagwan, grant me the energy to speak in a manner that brings closure and inner satisfaction to her mind so that she doesn't get hurt. Then tell file 1 as well. Sangeeta, speak in such a way that her mind finds closure and inner satisfaction. O Padmavati Devi, may her mind find closure and inner satisfaction. Remove all her obstacles. Say this 5 to 10 times. Then say the inner intent 10 to 15 times. And then, when the circumstances come together, tell her a couple of things. Dear, will you listen to me? Say it with love. She's not wrong at all. But we already blame her for doing something wrong and speak that way. Do you have any sense? How can you have a friend like that? She's bad for you. She has a boyfriend. Shouldn't you be cautious of all that? Why are you friends with her? She would be standing in front of us like an accused in a trial. What did I do wrong?
That's exactly what happens, Pujashree.
When you see her as guilty, she doesn't have any love for you. She feels, Mom has started her usual nagging. She's nagging. And then she and her sister will get together and start laughing at you.
Exactly. That's exactly what's happening in the house, Pujashree.
What can you do?
But Pujashree, we do have some expectations. We expect that our children shouldn't turn bad. So we end up saying something.
Yes, the expectations can be there. But in the first place, the children have to be yours. Then you can have expectations. For example, there was a man named Akarta Singh, and people told him, your daughter committed suicide. Sorry, not suicide. He was told, she was madly in love with someone, and she took an overdose of some medications. She's in a critical condition right now. What? This has happened to her? The poor fellow became disoriented. Then they told him, it wasn't your daughter, you're Akarta Singh. This happened to Karta Singh's daughter. Oh, really? You're not even married. I'm not married? Then he realized, she's not my daughter. I'm not even married. How foolish of me that I almost fainted. Only when someone explains to us do we understand. Just talking about it gave him depression and he almost fainted. But one has to know the difference between Karta Singh and Akarta Singh first. This isn't mine. And this is someone else's.
But Pujashree, I don't remember such things at that moment.
But we can ask her, did you like what I said?
She doesn't like it, Pujashree. I can see that.
Then we should keep calling and connecting with the God within her. What else can we do? Keep a habit of telling her something once or twice a month.
Jai Sachidanand Pujashree.
Dada has said that speech is a taped record from the last life. We also heard today that we must have observation on the speech that comes out. So I want to understand it further.
You have to understand what comes out is called discharge. But the speech that hasn't come out, we call it vyavasthit after the glass breaks. But we cannot say it's vyavasthit before it breaks.
One cannot say so.
Similarly, before speaking, decide, I want to speak in a manner where no one gets hurt. Then whatever comes out is correct. If there are mistakes in it, do pratikraman and turn back. Make a decision once again. You can do that, right?
Yes, I can.
So it is a record, but that can only be known after it happens. Don't people say, I have a short temper, I get angry at anyone. So do you get angry at the police? No, that doesn't happen.
In that case, the pure soul is seen first.
And there you go. When you see a car with blinking red and blue lights and the siren beeping, do you get angry there? Then what you're saying is wrong. You're defending yourself. I have a short temper. You want to scold the husband and the children, so you defend yourself by saying, my nature is such. Why don't you show your anger at the policeman? What is this like? It can be called vyavasthit after it comes out.
Vyavasthit.
You cannot say so beforehand. We have some sort of relative knowledge in that case. They are policemen. If we say anything wrong to them, they'll whack us even harder.
Okay.
Whereas, where are the husband and the children going to go? They're like domesticated cows. They're tied to a pillar. We can overpower them. It's no problem. They're not going to go anywhere.
That's true.
Our opinions are causing us to speak offensive speech. Our insistence is making us utter offensive speech. Our bad habit of making others follow our will is making us speak offensive speech. Such buttons are pressed behind this. If we change these buttons, then there'll be improvement.
So the observation needs to be made there?
Yes, to speak in a manner that doesn't hurt anyone. Does our speech hurt anyone?
Yes, that happens.
On what basis does this happen? We can catch when our speech hurts others. My speech is hurting others. Now, we want to go a step further. On what basis is it hurting someone? Which of our diseases is responsible for it? Do we want respect? Do we want others to follow our will? Have we taken a contract to improve everyone in the house?
It could be insistence.
You have to examine that. I don't need to say it.
That's usually prevalent.
But why is insistence there? Is it to do good for others? Is it to make others follow my will?
It's about, I am right.
Oh, I'm right. Examine that and find a solution.
Okay, Jai Sachidanand.
Usha Borad.
Pujishri, this is Rajan.
Yes, Rajan Bhai, your question hasn't come up, but go ahead.
Going back to what Piyush Bhai talked about, I want to tell him that he has a wonderful team. I don't know if a team of this level exists in the US. What I want to say is that the problems he mentioned are prevalent all around. It's not only here. New Mahatmas and old Mahatmas. I want to describe an incident that happened with us. In 2010, a retreat was organized in New York for the first time. We were all new, and for the first time we had organized the hall, the setup, and everything else. After setting up the stage with huge effort, we all went home. There were senior Mahatmas from New Jersey, Connecticut, and California who had all come. We go in the hall in the morning, and the entire stage has changed. Entirely changed. It was completely changed. Because of this, one of our organizers started having blood pressure problems. We had to take her to the hospital. We had to treat her for 2 hours. It's because she had put in a lot of effort. So, everyone wants to do seva. Especially when you come, there are no boundaries, all limits. Pujishri, Pujishri, Pujishri. From the back door, from the front door, and from everywhere. What I want to say is that this problem exists everywhere. But in the end of the day, everyone is together. Jai Sachidanand.
Yes, but what solution did you bring about?
Pujishri, the solution was...
Keep the blood pressure medication handy. That's it. Keep the doctor around.
Not blood pressure medicine. After 2 to 3 days, they calm down and understand the situation. This is Dada's work, and we will all get together and work. But first, there's a surge like boiling milk. It overflows and everything happens. People begin to cry. They end up taking medicine in the bathroom, etc. But then they recover.
What this is like is heated iron balls continue to cool down. In all this, develop a system. Find out what is the possible solution. And we want to gradually develop all that. That's why we've arranged the NCC, the National Coordination Committee, so that everyone can be aware of new systems. They can keep developing new systems and continue finding solutions. And if problems are faced while working, that feedback also comes in. We can even ask them how to solve these problems. Everyone should get together, discuss, and solve the problems.
As Dada says, no law is the law. Ultimately, that applies.
Yes, that's true, but no one should get hurt. For example, if other Mahatmas completed the seva, we should be happy. We shouldn't feel hurt. That's the state we want to achieve.
That starts from the third day, not on the first 2 days.
That's it then. Third day means, at the end of the day, if you get that result, in the interim, the karmic stock got discharged. And you were in Gnan before as well as after the incident. In the interim, the karmic stock came to fruition and got discharged.
Not on the first 2 days, but on the third day. They touch each other's feet.
They ask for forgiveness.
They hug each other. All that happens. But the 2 days?
That's it then. All is well that ends well.
Jai Sachidanand.
But we should be prepared, okay? Our old Mahatmas, meaning the people who have been selected for seva, and the new uncertified people who just turn up, they come unofficially. There wasn't an official decision that they'll do seva here, but they just show up. We have to understand that this is how it's going to be, but internally, we shouldn't get into any suffering. Gradually, bring about such solutions with wisdom, that love and oneness don't break. Jai Sachidanand.